Okay, here we are, checking out the Hunter's Glade. It's a new home currently on the PTS. Should be available in the game pretty soon with the Wolf Hunter DLC coming out, or sometime around there. It's a large home, and it's going to be crowns only. There's no listed gold purchase price. It's pretty much par for the course with the larger homes. So, let's check it out. This is the entrance. You come in here, and there's a little stairway leading down. Tower area. Well, I should probably mention it's going to be located in the Rift, right here, close to Riften, actually just right outside of it. Up here. Okay. You come in here. Here's your portal room. It's kind of cool. The leaves blowing around. And a giant monolith. And if you go down here, there's a nice, good sized little room area. Fireplace. Go hit that portal. Okay. Once you get out here, this is the bulk of the home. It's really just a giant outdoor space. Lots of waterfalls. Seems to be the new thing for the large homes. Waterfalls everywhere. It's lots of land to cover around though. Lots of really big trees too. It's pretty nice. Over here. Lots of swimming, big overhang. You can come out over on this side. See, there's that overhang. Not sure, but you might be able to build up to that and make something up on top of there. Not real sure, but could be a thing. Over here, you got the giant monolith. If you can read Daedric, you might be able to decipher what that says. Here. And it's kind of just an open landscape. gives you a lot of freedom to kind of build and do what you want to do with it. More waterfalls? That one I don't think you're gonna want to jump down through. There's my favorite part, it's the giant moon. It just looks amazing in the night sky up here. Another little outcropping that you can access over here. Look, more waterfalls. It really is beautiful though. Like, just all around down there. As you can see from the map, it's quite a big chunk of land, especially considering you've got the indoor tower area back inside. So there's a lot of stuff you could do with it. Okay, so we'll check it out furnished. Get a little extra foliage around, get some really nice carcasses, kind of spruce up the place. And got a nice little altar over here that comes with it furnished. Lots of dead stuff. The perfect place for a werewolf to call home. And again, over here. A few decorations kind of scattered around. Got that giant skull up there on top of the monolith. Back over here towards the portal, and you get a nice Hircine statue. I'm gonna check out the inside real quick. Okay. It doesn't look like they really added much in this room. Come down here and more carcasses. Waterfalls and carcasses. If that's your bag, then this is the home for you. There's probably not going to be much of anything up here. Check it out just in case. Yeah. like that portal though. It looks really cool. That's just kind of something that'd be fun to have inside your house. Okay, so we are on PTS. So everything's one crown on PTS. So we don't have an actual price for it. I'm sure it'll be in line with the other notable homes that they've released in the past. Probably in the ballpark of about 15,000-16,000 crowns. Unfurnished and furnished, probably 18,000-19,000. So we'll go ahead and buy it. And we'll see what kind of storage we're looking at. Probably be the standard 700. So yeah, 700 total furnishings, 10 special, 100 collectible furnishings, and 10 special collectibles with a population limit of 24. So it's exactly the same as the other notable homes, which is, I've said it before, I'll say it again, that I feel like 700 is too little for a space this large. Especially a space that is essentially in a blank canvas like this one, because it begs to be filled up and built inside. But it is what it is. So there it is. I think it's really beautiful, but with the item limit, I think what you can do with it will be fairly limited, because if I were to own it, I would want to build structures outside, or some kind of structure, and I feel like with a 700 item limit, that's going to be difficult. But it is really cool, and if you're a werewolf and you're into werewolves, it's kind of the perfect home for that. So, there it is. I hope you liked it, and if it's something that you think you might want, you don't have to wait too long, I don't think. I think it should be coming with Wolf Hunter DLC. So thanks for watching.